The past few months I've been on a mission to learn about what it takes to make a game. From nothing. Like, actually nothing. Except in graphics. We started here. Over this time, I've had a little series going where most of my videos started with non-game dev blank. Like, non-game dev tries learning Godot, and non-game dev tries to make enemy AI. But it's time for a change. In my last video, I mentioned that with the game nearly finished, I would be making one final devlog on the game before I release it into the wild for free. And, well, this is that devlog. I've been hard at work using everything that I've learned up until this point to improve the game as much as a non-game dev can. Let's take a look at what I've been working on. There's something that I heard while working on the game that I thought was interesting, which is essentially that the first 90% of work on a game accounts for 90% of your dev time, and the last 10% of work accounts for the other 90%. Now that I've been finishing my game, I get it. I started off with three big ideas that I wanted to implement before I put it up for download, but this quickly grew into, well, the other 90%. Let's start off with big idea number one. The first thing I did was to make it so the game is able to run on any screen size. In order to make this improvement, I had to completely break my game because of the way that I coded everything in the past when I wasn't thinking about different screen sizes. All the spawning in the game, from the coins to the enemies, used hard-coded spawning positions based on a 1920 by 1080 monitor, and as soon as the monitor wasn't that size anymore, enemies would spawn in front of you, coins would spawn outside the barrier, and doing anything to fix it would break the game even more. Eventually, by focusing on one small part of the game at a time, I was able to get everything working again. I think. I say this because I gave the game to my friend who has a different monitor resolution, and all the menus except the settings menu were very off-centered. I'm not sure why, because I tested his resolution in Godot by changing the viewport size and everything seemed fine on my end, but since the settings menu was working, I was able to use that as a template to make the rest of the menus centered as well. At this point, 2 weeks passed and the game looked almost identical as it did before this. But now more people should be able to play it, so I think that should count for something. Let's get to the new content now. Big idea number two was simple. I want a boss. Of course, it's not like I can just click. What does my to-do list look like to add a boss? Well, it's going to need a sprite. It's also going to need different attack animations, and I also want to make some new music for when you're fighting it. Finally, what happens when you beat it? Let's start with the sprite. Alright, now the attack animations. The first attack I had in mind was a spin attack, which was pretty easy to do with Godot's animation player. After some smoothing, this is what we have. It starts out with a slow partial turn, which is my attempt at telegraphing to the player what the boss is going to do. Next, I made an attack where he charges at the player. For this, I needed a way to temporarily change the speed of the boss so it looks like he's rushing you down. I made a variable named attack speed and I added the export annotation to it so it shows up in the inspector panel. Then in the animation player, I added some keyframes to change the value to first make the boss slow down as a way to telegraph what it's about to do, then charge, then recover back to its normal speed. I then multiplied this to the boss's velocity function, and we have a boss that's able to charge at you. For the third attack, I made it so he can spawn enemies with a little shake. If his health is above 50%, he'll spawn 5 red enemies, or if it's below 50%, it'll be 5 B orange enemies. Speaking of health, I made his health bar with a texture progress bar node in 3 textures, one for the under texture, one for the over, and one for the progress. Honestly, I was really amazed at how simple this was to get working. For the boss music, I really just had one goal, and that was to make something stressful. I spent a couple days messing around on LMMS, and eventually, this is what I got. Thank you. Out of all the music I made for the game, this one is my favorite. I just feel like I had an idea for the tone that I wanted, and this is that tone. Now I needed to get the song to loop, but I didn't want the beginning to be a part of the loop. How I did this was I exported the song in two parts, the part I don't want to loop, and the part that I do. I then set up a signal in Godot to listen for when the beginning section finishes, which will then trigger the rest of the song to play, but now as a loop. That way, the beginning will only play once. So we had this boss, and a way to beat him, but what happens after that? Up until now, this game is programmed to go on forever. It's been this thing where you see how long you can survive and get the most points. But what would it look like if it ended after you beat the boss? I think I have an idea, but first we'll need a little death animation, sound effect, and a song that plays when you win. We need some high scores. I want them to be saved and loaded between play sessions, so when the game ends, either by dying or defeating the boss, you can add your name into the high scores, if it's in the top 10 scores that are saved. But how would I track high scores? It would be easy enough if the goal was to just get the most points, but the boss is set to appear at 5,000 points, then the game ends after that. I think I got it. What if I make three different tiers of high scores? First will be the points. If you lose the game anytime before reaching 5,000 points, your point score will be saved to show how far you made it. Next will be if you lose while battling the boss. Since the maximum amount of points you can get is 5,000, your high score won't be saved as points anymore. Instead, it will be the percent of the boss you defeated based on the health that you took away. So if you took away 60% of the boss's health, your high score will show as 60%. Finally, if you beat the boss, your high score will show as your final time, which is what this timer is for right here. So the fastest times will show at the top of the high scores. This might be a weird system, but it was a really fun programming challenge to figure out how to get it working. I'd probably want to figure out a more elegant solution in future games, though. I'm learning. But check out the high scores page! I made separate tabs depending on the difficulty to keep the high scores fair. And I also finally learned how to make custom themes, which I applied to all the buttons and menus. We have another problem though. It would be really difficult, but technically possible that someone could avoid buying the laser from the shop, make it to the boss, and not have any way to progress. This would be a crazy scenario because of how many enemies would be chasing after them, but let's cover all our bases here. Maybe instead of starting the player off empty-handed, we can give them a tiny laser at the beginning. That way, at least they can deal some damage. Continuing with the shop, I made a few more additions. First, you can now upgrade your laser to do double damage. I also made an upgraded shield which can tank two hits instead of one. And maybe my favorite, you can now buy a boost! I made this in the same way that I made the charge attack for the boss, with a variable and animation player combo to increase the player's speed temporarily. The trail behind the player is just a sprite with its opacity changing over time, and the sound effect I made an LMMS. There's a few other smaller things I added too, like I learned how to change the boot screen and the game icon, I added controller support, I added little particles to the coin, I added a little background animation to the arena using a GPU Particles 2D node and the ability to turn this off. I added some UI for when points or money is added to your total from beating enemies or collecting coins. I made the mouse invisible during gameplay so it doesn't get in the way. I made some stylized titles for the different menus as well as the countdown. And I also fixed a lot of bugs. I gave the game to some friends to playtest, and I guess you could say that a few game-breaking bugs snuck past me, like coins spawning outside the barrier towards the end of the game, and beating the boss then being awarded with a game over screen. Whoops. But now that those bugs have been fixed, at least the bugs that I know about, it's crazy to think that I'm moving on from this game. The purpose of this game was to learn about game development and what goes into it. I might still be an amateur, but I can confidently say that working on this game has taught me a lot. When I started, I didn't know what nodes were, I didn't know how to spawn enemies, but I knew that I would eventually figure it out. And through some persistence and a lot of help from you guys, we now have a little playable game. With that, I think there's only one thing left to do. You see, I added a quick little animation of the barrier closing in around you when you start the game, and another animation of the barrier disappearing off-screen when you win. It gives me the impression that the only way to escape from this rectangular prison is to beat the boss that trapped you in there. I think I finally have a name for this game. I want to thank you guys again for the support you've been giving me as I continue to learn game development. I already have an idea for the game I want to work on next. It's going to be a completely new genre than this one, so I'm looking forward to a lot more learning, and probably a lot more fumbling too. But that's all part of the learning process. If learning things from scratch is interesting to you, I'd love for you to follow along and subscribe, and maybe even start a project of your own. In the meantime, I put Escape the Shape up on itch.io as a free download, so give it a try and let me know your best scores. The link is in the description, and I'll see you in the next video. Keep learning.